Today we're working on a 2008 Dodge Ram 2500 with a 6.7 liter Cummins engine. And we're going to replace this EGR pressure sensor, or some may refer to it as an exhaust back pressure sensor. And so it's located kind of in the EGR passageway here in the front corner of the engine here. This is going to be on the passenger side front corner. And so it's just got an electrical connector right up front here. We're able to disconnect this. This has a little bit of an interesting story on why we're replacing it though. The customer had a concern with lack of throttle response. The transmission was stuck in overdrive and just a lot of interesting drivability concerns. The lightning bolt, which indicates a throttle problem, was illuminated on the dash. There's a ton of trouble codes. So as you can see here, we've got a lot of different trouble codes here, which all pointed to a failure of the 5-volt reference circuit. So the technician systematically unplugged one component on the circuitry at a time to see if that 5-volt reference would come back. In this case, it was our EGR pressure sensor, which was shorted out internally, drawing down the rest of the 5-volt circuit for all the other sensors. So we're gonna replace it today. In order to replace it, I just got my ratchet and extension. Then I've got a 1 1/16 inch socket. So this is kind of like an oil pressure sending unit socket. And I'm gonna slide it right over this thing in place. And we're going to slide it right out. So now I've got it removed. There's a little O-ring on here. And we wanna make sure that came out. Our new one also has an O-ring, so we're gonna make sure that it's gonna seal properly. It's sometimes not a bad idea to have an assistant quickly start the truck and shut it off, just to make sure that we don't have any restrictions in this passage here. If we're not getting any exhaust gas flowing through here, now we might have a plugged passageway. So keep an eye on that. Once we've verified all that, we can simply take our new sensor and we're gonna thread it into place. We're gonna torque it down to spec. We're gonna reconnect our electrical circuit, clear any trouble codes that were set, and verify that this is working properly. Hopefully now you have a better understanding of why you might want to and how to replace this EGR pressure sensor on a 6.7 liter Cummins engine.